people living near, living in Shawnee are getting some new unwelcome neighbors.
40 acres of land in the Crimson Ridge development is slated to become a habitat for snakes. KMBC 9's Haley Harrison talked to residents who say if it happened in their neighborhood, it could happen in yours. Haley?
Well, that's right, Kelly. The idea is to import a couple species of snakes here and put them in this park. But you can see that this park is not far at all from the backyards of the homes in this neighborhood. And neighbors here tell me those snakes are going to be too close for comfort.
The creek in 9-year-old Kyle Moyla's backyard is about to become a safe haven. Not for kids, but snakes.
I hate snakes.
A group called Habitat Kansas plans to import red bellies and smooth earth snakes to 40 acres of parkland in Shawnee's Crimson Ridge neighborhood.
It's really disappointing. It's not what we expected.
Kyle's dad, Dan, says once the snakes move in, neighbors have been told their kids won't be welcome to play here anymore. Moyla doesn't think it would be safe either.
They won't understand it. You know, my younger kids, how do you just say we can't go down there, you know? This is what we've lived with all our lives.
I think it's wrong.
Neighbors considering a lawsuit say it has been an exhaustive effort.
I'm trying to think when I slept and I'm trying to think when I shaved last. it's consuming.
Residents like Tony Lauer paid a premium for this real estate neighboring the park, reassured by a promise it would always be there for his family.
Designed to preserve and protect the beauty, integrity, and value of your neighborhood for years to come. That's what I want.
Tonight, we wanted to talk to the folks who are behind the plans to put the snakes here in this park, but our calls and emails to Habitat Kansas and the developer of this community, Rod Rock, were not returned. Reporting live in Shawnee, Haley Harrison, KMBC 9 News.
All right, thank you, Haley. Habitat Kansas is a for-profit business that conserves land that needs restoration and receives government credits for the work.